Welcome back, Tigers. Today we're going to learn how to set up Einstein Next Best Action to help your users understand what step they should take next from a record. If you haven't explored this feature, we highly recommend you look into it and see how it can help your users. In our example, we have a complicated sales process with multiple screen flows launched from the opportunity. We're going to use Einstein Next Best Action to surface different recommendations to different types of users. Let's hop over to Salesforce and see how to set up Einstein Next Best Action using a predefined set of recommendations. Here we are in Salesforce, and the first thing I want to show you is how to review your limits for Einstein Next Best Action. You're going to go to Setup, and then you'll go to Company Information. You'll scroll down here to Maximum Next Best Action Requests Available, and you'll see that you do get 5,000 of these every month. Now, each time the Einstein Next Best Action component shows to a user, that counts as one. We're going to show you how you can limit the number of times that people see the same recommendation in a future video, and we'll also show you how you can limit this component from being seen if there's no recommendations for a user. Next thing we want to review are our flows. So we have three different flows that users will invoke from an opportunity, and they are screen flows. We have opportunity request final quote, opportunity approve decline pricing, and opportunity request pricing approval. You'll see that these are all screen flows. Now, Einstein Next Best Action can also be used with an auto launch flow. I personally don't like the way it works. Whenever a user launches an action from Einstein Next Best Action, it's just weird. If it invokes an auto launch flow, it gives the user a message that says your flow is finished and the user is a little confused by what just happened after they click the button. There's no success message, no error message. So I prefer not to use the auto launch flows. Now we will review how we built each of these flows in a different video. We're not going to go into those today. This first one is going to allow a sales user to request the final quote. It asks them to provide the DocuSign signer information, and then that triggers an update to the opportunity and sends out a request to send out the DocuSign document. This flow is going to allow a sales manager to approve or decline pricing. Now, we only want this recommendation to show to sales managers, so we'll show you how that works. This third flow we want to set up to allow the sales user to request pricing approval from their sales manager. So this one should only be visible to a sales user. Now, if we go to Einstein Next Best Action in Setup, you will see here that we have no strategies set up. If you click New Strategy, it's going to ask you two different options. One is Continue in Strategy Builder, and one is Create in Flow Builder. Strategy Builder is the old technology for Einstein Next Best Action, and I don't recommend that you use it. It's not going to be supported going forward, and everything needs to be built in Flow. It's also not that fun to use. You have a lot more functionality in Flow, so we definitely recommend that you create any recommendation strategy using Flow Builder. When you click Create in Flow Builder, it will take you straight over to your normal flow screen. And then you're going to click All plus Templates, and you're going to choose Recommendation Strategy. Now, before we're ready to start building our recommendation strategy, we have to have recommendations set up in Salesforce already, because we're going to set up what are called predefined recommendations. There are also recommendations called on-the-fly recommendations, which we will show you how to create in the next video. In order to get to recommendations in your org, you will go to the nine dots, type in recommendations, and then you probably won't see it if you've never gone to it before. So you will need to enable the tab for your profile. And we'll come back here and refresh. And now we can see the recommendations tab. So we'll click new here. And there's another thing that's a little bit of annoying to me, and it's this drop down is in a place in a page where you can't see the full name of the flow. So we're going to fix that right away. Recommendations is an object in your org where you can configure the page layout. You can add fields to it, so it functions just like any other object in your org. We're going to go ahead and modify this page layout so that it's easier to see the full name of our flow. There we go. All right, our first recommendation is going to be opportunity request pricing approval. The description that you put here is the description that is going to show to the user. And now we have the option to set the acceptance label and the rejection label. We're only going to use actions that have an acceptance in this video. So it really doesn't matter what you put in your rejection label because it's not going to show to the user. For our action, this is where you're going to select which flow it is that you want this recommendation to show. So it's going to be called Opportunity Request Pricing Approval. Next, we have to upload an image for the user to use. Now these images are stored in your asset library. And we have an image that we've uploaded already, so we'll use that. And I'll show you in the next one how you upload images and what settings they have to have in order to show in Einstein Next Best Action. We'll save that. This is what your recommendation should look like. We will create the next one and clone it. This is going to be the request final quote. This will be the acceptance label will be called request final quote. And then we'll change that to select the appropriate flow. We'll click save here. Now I want to show you what happens when you upload an image using this section right here. So if you upload an image, it doesn't give you the ability to specify any settings for this particular asset file. Then what ends up happening is this image does not show up in your Einstein Next Best Action action. Took me a lot to figure out what was wrong with what I was doing. Let me show you how you should upload your asset files so you don't have to go into the developer console and then set the appropriate settings for your asset file. I'm going to delete this file that I just uploaded through the recommendation page. I'm going to go to my asset library, and then I'm going to click upload asset file. And then you need to make sure that these two checkboxes are checked so that they show in your action. We'll then come back over here. We'll click edit and we'll make sure that we trash this one and we will select the request quote and click save. Now we need to create our third recommendation. This will be called Opportunity Approved Decline Pricing. We'll set the description and the acceptance label, and then we'll change our flow to point to the correct flow. And we'll save this. So now we have all of our recommendations set up. So now it's time to start our flow. We're going to first do a get, and we're going to get our recommendations. We will select the recommendation object. And then we're going to query for the name starts with opportunity. Now, this may not be ideal for you because this requires you to start all of your recommendation records with the name opportunity. If you change the name of the record, then this query will no longer work. Keep in mind, you can use a custom field on your recommendation object. Maybe in this case, you could create a pick list that's called object, and then you would fill that out when you create your recommendation records. I'm going to select all records here. And then my next step is to create a decision element. Our decision element is going to look for our current user's role. and this is going to be the Eastern sales team role. The next one is going to be our sales manager role. Then we're going to filter our recommendations. You'll choose the Get Recommendations there, and I'm going to filter based on name. You'll select an or here. And then we are going to add these to a collection variable called Output Recommendations. This is a variable that's created automatically with these types of flows that are called recommendation strategies. Next, we'll configure the recommendations for our sales manager. We'll do a filter on the Get Recommendations. And this is going to look for the name as well. We will add that to the Output Recommendations variable. And make sure you choose the right filter here. And then we'll click save, and that's it. Click to activate. Then we're all ready. Now we're ready to add our Einstein Next Best Action element to our opportunity page. We're going to go to the opportunity object, and we'll go to the lightning record page. We will drag and drop the Einstein Next Best Action element onto the page. You can call this whatever you want. You can choose whether or not you want to hide the Einstein header or not. We need to make the strategy source flow builder. And then our maximum number of recommendations that we can show is 4. We're gonna hide the empty component, and we're going to not show the title. We do wanna show the image and description, and we do not wanna show the reject option. We don't have any flows being launched on that option. We also don't have any additional component visibility filters to put here right now. You may want to limit certain profiles from seeing this component so that it limits the number of times that it's shown. But in our case, recommendations are only going to be shown for 2 different types of roles. So we're pretty specific here in how we're deciding when to show recommendations. Then you'll click save. Right, I just wanted to show you something here. I had typed in the number and I didn't select from the dropdown, and my settings weren't saved and I was only seeing 1 recommendation. All right, so now we're going to test and make sure that we can see all the recommendations that we can. I'm going to hop over to an opportunity. My current role is Eastern Sales Team. Now, if I click Request Pricing Approval, it does launch the flow and it gives me my success message and tells me that my stage should update to proposal price quote. One of the things that happens in Einstein Next Best Action is that the browser does not automatically refresh. We're gonna show you in a future video how you can force a browser refresh so the user isn't confused by whether or not their action really did do something and they don't have to manually refresh the browser to see their updates happen. Next, we're gonna test as a sales manager. So I've got this user here whose role is VP North American Sales. I'll log in as the sales manager and we'll go to the same opportunity. And then we can see that we see the approved decline pricing flow, which is perfect. I'll click this button and just make sure that it works. I can approve the pricing. I get the success message that says it was approved. I'll click finish and we're all set. You've successfully set up your predefined recommendations for Einstein Next Best Action. Nice job. That's it. That's a wrap. Be sure to subscribe to Blue Tiger Academy so you don't miss the next video we are working on that will show you how to use Einstein Next Best Action with DocuSign. DocuSign buttons use custom buttons that invoke a visual force page. We will show you how to convert this to a screen flow so you can show this action as a recommendation to your users. Let us know in the comments below if you have any questions or if you would like to see a video on a different Salesforce topic. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.